Okay everyone, today we're going to do a slightly different video than normal. What we're actually going to do is actually go over our camera equipment, because a lot of you have been asking about it. What cameras do we use and so forth? So what we're going to do, talk about the cameras, the equipment with it, including things like gimbals, the lenses, and even what type of memory cards we use in the actual cameras. Where can you go and meet hundreds of people just like you, strengthen existing relationships and forge new ones with vendors and distributors, and meet some of the biggest names in the industry, where you can go and see the newest tech and services that you need to make your IT business grow. And there'll be thousands of pounds worth of prizes up for grabs. Then what's more, you'll get that for a quid. TechMax 2023 will be on the 23rd of June at Magna Adventure and Science Centre near Meadowhall in Sheffield. This event will be over four times larger than last year's event, and this year's event will incorporate a live tech award, dedicated meeting rooms, demo and interactive areas, and up to 800 other techs just like you. Get registered now at tftmax.com. Okay, so this is our main camera. The one you saw in the intro is actually the one I'm filming on at the moment, which is usually used as our backup camera now, or if we're doing some gimbal work. If you're not sure what a gimbal is, I'll show you that in a few minutes. But this is the main camera. This is a Canon EOS R5C camera. The C specifically stands for cinema camera, so this is designed specifically to film cinema work. For example, it's Netflix approved. That means if you was to film obviously properly and edit it properly and everything like that, you could actually film a feature film on this camera. Bear in mind, the camera itself isn't all this. There's a lot added onto it, obviously, to help us do our work. So first thing we've got is the lens on the front. We do have multiple different other lenses. You can see here, it does extend and go in and so forth. I won't go to all the dynamics, but this is a lens we use for, again, around about 90-95% of our work. It's one lens what does pretty much most things we need. On the end of it, we do have a little cap which we can adjust, which allows it to get rid of certain rays of light on pictures, so you don't get like reflections. For example, if you were doing a picture of water, you normally get that shimmer on top and you can't really see what's underneath. If we turn this the end of the lens, it then gets rid of that shimmer and allows you to see underneath the water from above, and it also stops shiny bits on packaging and stuff like that, which is what we mainly use it for. So this camera is capable of 8K footage. So normally, obviously, most TVs are either HD or 4K, which is ultra HD. This is capable of 8K, so it's even higher quality. We normally shoot in 4K and it's sort of upsampled in 8K, which without getting too technical, it basically improves the quality. But as you can see, this is the camera. You've got the lens there, as we said, you can extend it and so forth. We do have multiple other lenses. We'll talk about those in a few seconds. We've got this black cage what goes around, which allows us to mount different things onto the camera. So for example, on this at the moment, I've got a battery pack set up on the top. I can attach that to the sides if I want it, or the bottom. We do have a handle here which we sometimes have positioned on there. It can be mounted either way, so it allows us to do sweeping shots so we can go with ease, and it makes it nice and smooth. Also, this brown handle on the side is an addition as well, which is attached to the frame. That allows us to hold it smoother. So normally if you hold a camera like that, you're holding it one hand and it can make your hand shake quite a bit, especially with these because they get quite heavy. But we're having this second handle, it allows nice smooth movements without worrying about shaking. Now this camera allows us to do 120 frames per second as well in 4K. We generally record in sort of a raw format without getting too technical, which does take up a lot of storage space. Hence this camera needs can take two camera cards. You can take an SD card as well as a CF Express Type B card, which we'll go to those in a few minutes and I'll tell you which ones we prefer as well. It's also got a little monitor on here, so you can open that up, as you can see, It sees what we see. We can do all the focusing and stuff from there if we want to, or even pictures and so on. So we, even though this is a cinema camera, it is also a traditional camera as well. It's sort of a two-in-one camera. I know a lot of cameras can do that, but this is specifically a cinema style camera rather than a camera with video capabilities. This is basically a proper camera with a proper cinema camera built in, so it's sort of a proper two-in-one. And they're not cheap, so if you look it up online, you'll be looking a good few grand for a camera like that, and that's before you put the lenses and the additional things on. The reason we have a battery pack on there is so we can film longer and do more stuff, because the built-in batteries, if you've got it on camera mode, or should I say video mode, only last around about 20 minutes, so you need an external battery to keep the power going through. With the screen here, as we mentioned, it can be tilted, turned, whatever way we want, so you can see, obviously, whatever angle you are to the screen, what you're actually wanting to see, and so forth. So if you're sitting, standing at the side, like I am at the moment with this camera, I can see exactly what I'm filming, so I know it's in focus, and so forth. Also on top of this brown bit, we've got our microphone. We use one of two microphones. We usually use this one mainly if we're going out to do events. It's got batteries built inside of it as well, which allows it to boost the volume, so increase the gain, and which obviously helps with our recording recording quality. You find there's a huge difference when using a microphone like this than something what's built in. We've also got another one we use if we need to go more a lighter route. It's good, but not as good as that. And again, we use Rode microphones. We do really prefer those. We also use a wireless one usually when we're in the studio, like now. So that one's got a lapel mic on it. The wireless receiver looks like that. That attaches to me. There's another one with a little screen, which we normally attach to the camera there. But obviously, as I'm using it at this moment in time, it's obviously you can't see it. But the wireless one's ideal because it, no matter where you are or how far from the camera, it's giving you that constant same volume of sound, so it's not going up and down and so forth. And having the lapel mic, we can just attach it to a shirt, which you'll probably see on the intro. You'll see a little near one of my buttons, a little lapel mic, so which you'll find like a lot of TV studios and stuff like that use, like on the news and stuff like that. Right, okay, so that's the basics to the camera itself. There are a few other bits we do have and can do, but the basics is it's a very powerful camera capable of doing very high quality pictures as well as a very high quality video. But bear in mind, one thing to say, when you do record video with this properly, when you actually export it onto your PC, it comes out looking very grey because you have to add the colour in yourself, basically by using what's called LUTs or adjusting the colour profiles within your editing software, for example, Adobe Premiere Pro with what we use. Otherwise, it will look very flat and grey. And this is also capable of HDR content, which you will start seeing in a lot of our stuff because we've only had this camera about a month. Okay, let me run you through some of the lenses. Obviously, you saw the one that was on the camera. We've also got one on this camera, which we use probably the second most, to be honest with you. And then we've got these two here. This isn't actually a lens, this is an adapter which allows us to put older lenses onto newer equipment like our newer camera without having to go out and spend thousands of pounds on new camera equipment. To be honest, we don't use this very often, but this is a very good telescopic lens, so it lets you zoom all the way in and out. It goes between a rating of 55 and 250, which probably doesn't mean much to you, but it allows you to zoom in quite far if needed. Again, when we're in a studio, you're generally pretty close to the camera, so you don't need to zoom in up your nose and see all your nostril hairs. Now, that's the adapter. As I says, we'd attach that onto there, and it allows us to use it on the new cameras. And this one we do use now and again. This we use for macro shots. It looks quite small. It's got obviously autofocus, stabilization, and all this, that, and the other on it. If I open the end, you can see the actual lens there. It's actually quite small. But this is designed for doing real close-up work, so you can basically see each individual grain of salt, or if you're doing like zooming into like a keyboard, you can see the textures on the keys and stuff like that, so you can get really close. You've got sort of macro lenses built into things like smartphones these days, some of the high-end models like the iPhone 14 Pro, I think it is, and a lot of the Max models, they do have that ability as well. This does actually have a light ring on it as well, which we can change obviously the brightness of that. So if you are in a dark area or if you're getting too close, it will actually light the area up, so you can actually take a pretty good picture. Personally, I prefer not to use lights on devices directly like this because it can make the image look a bit too coarse and so forth. I prefer more natural or a surround light option like we have in our studio. But that's it for the lenses. So in most of our cameras, we use what's called an SD card, which is this thing here. You may have seen these around in a lot of cameras, micro versions and so forth, but there are different speed ratings and so forth. We need a very high one to use, and especially the newer camera, because the newer camera, when we're taking doing videos and stuff, it needs a very fast card. Now bear in mind, if we're taking the full advantage of our new camera, doesn't matter how fast this card is, just will not take the do the job, because it's just not fast enough. And that's where these compact flash cards or CF Express type B cards come in. Now this card can read at 1900 megabytes per second or write at 1700, compared to this one here, the SD card, which is 300 and 260. So you can see that there's a big difference in the actual speeds, and the camera, the main camera we use, has to basically film on this card all the time. If we're doing pictures, because the camera can take two cards, we generally have this card in and one of these. So when we're taking pictures, it records the pictures to this, and when we're doing video, it will record it to this. You can also set the camera up to basically, if you're taking pictures, to record to both at the same time, but for the video you can't do that because this card isn't fast enough. Because believe it or not, this camera is capable of recording up to 1700 megabytes per second. Now, talking about camera cards, if you notice, all our stuff here is Lexar, and the reason we use Lexar is because we find that it is very reliable. We've never had an issue with that. We've used lots of other brands. I'm not going to name them out, name and shame or anything like that, but we always find a consistent speed and reliable. We've never had a fail on the Lexar. We even use the Lexar solid state drives, the NM800, and I think there's a few other versions. I think it's 760 and so forth, in our video editing machines as well, because we know they won't have an issue. Well, you never know 100%, but generally there's very small chance you're going to have an issue. Where other brands might tell you, yes, they're really good and this, that and the other, but to be honest, we tend to prefer to stick to the Lexar. We know what we're going to get if we're going to buy it. Now, one of the things to bear in mind when you are buying cards like these is there's always a read and a write speed, and a lot of cards will only tell you the read speed on there, or they'll hide the write speed on the back. They'll give you a really fast read speed of 300 megabytes per second or 100 or whatever it may be, depending on the card, but the write speed is only 10 megabytes or something like that. So just watch out for that if you are buying a cards, is the write speeds are actually, for us, the most important part, not the read, because when you're recording stuff onto the cards, you're writing onto the cards. The read speed is only good for playing back the files or copying them off of that device. So if you're writing and you've got a camera like our main camera, which can record up to 1700 megabytes per second, then that would be ideal. But obviously if your card only did 1000, then it's not going to do the job. We also use Lexar card readers as well. This one's for the CF Express type B card. It allows us to transfer the data across onto the machine extremely fast. It takes seconds basically to copy a video file over. And this has got a USB type C and A connection as well, which is good. And then we've got a standard USB type A connection for the standard SD cards. Don't get me wrong, it's like USB 3.1, so it's really fast. So that allows us to transfer the data onto our main editing PC, which then gets backed up onto our server automatically anyway. But that gives you an idea of the cards we use. So if you are looking for a decent card, you're not sure, I would suggest giving the Lexars a go. Don't get me wrong, there are others out there as well. Okay, now we've got gimbals. I'll show you how the one on the left works, but the one on the right works pretty much exactly the same, but it's for connecting bigger cameras up like the one I'm filming off of, and that's what we usually use this camera on, is this. So I'll run you through how it works on this one. So what a gimbal is basically a control stick, so you can hold it, you can usually mount it on the floor or the ground and stuff like that, which is really good. But then you attach, for example, on this one, a smartphone, as I said, this one, a traditional camera. And what you do is when you're filming and moving around, you'll notice the camera or the actual phone will stay pointing at that direction no matter what. Or you can do different things. You can get it to move around slowly, which it takes its time to do, but you can alter the settings. We usually get it to do things like time lapses, so you can record, you can tell it, oh, I want to start recording there and take a minute to get round to there and record to there. We can also zoom in and out using it as well. So you've got all the functionality there that allows you to do some really cool looking, smooth movements and stuff like that, which you can't do naturally because obviously, don't matter how steady your hands are, they will shake to a certain degree. And this just makes it nice and smooth and gives you those panning shots. You can also use them for time lapses. People use them for doing stuff like taking pictures of the stars, and you'll see these really cool pictures of the stars flying over and stuff like that. And that's what the sort of thing they tend to use. So again, they're both pretty much the same sort of thing, but this is just designed for a bigger camera. Where this one is designed more for a smartphone. And these ones are from the manufacturer, I think they're pronounced Xeon or Zion or something like that. That's the Smart 4, if I remember right, and that's the Weeble 3. So it gives you a good idea. We're pretty happy with these, to be honest with you. I've not had any issues, but again, you have to calibrate them and set them all up. But that gives you a basic idea of some of the equipment we use. Don't get me wrong, we've got turntables, tripods, and lots of other things, lighting equipment. That gives you an idea of the main camera equipment itself. I hope you enjoyed this video and know I did. Why not check out one of our other videos by clicking this box up here or this one just down here. Otherwise, you can give us a thumbs up, like, subscribe, comment below, let us know what you think, and we'll see you next time.